Coming up on this edition of Hawkeye News.
We have information on all the events happening after press time, senior walk, prom, and the big event, graduation, as we prepare to say farewell to the class of 2004. Details straight ahead.
Plus, Rogue ISD's first canine narcotics dog, Hawk, says farewell as he is set to retire after serving the Red Oak ISD Police Department for almost 9 years. An emotional tribute to a loyal officer coming up.
Also later, Hawkeye News crime reporter Natalie Hillary will bring us the final details on the new drug testing policy for extracurricular activities next year. News you can use later in our show.
Aloha to Mr. Rick Jackson. School board president Mr. Jackson and his wife Vicki will be leaving the nest of Red Oak and moving to Hawaii in late May. We have highlights from the emotional farewell concert.
And finally, it's time once again for all of us to take our embarrassment as producer Alan Oliver brings us one more look at those bloopers, blunders, and outtakes from the entire year of Hawkeye News. All coming up next on the season finale of Hawkeye News.
You're watching Hawkeye News with Rachel Selvey and Christian Henson. Sports with Brady Sapp. News coverage from the Junior High Bureau with Katie Stanglin. Plus, academic and student life reports with our Hawkeye News team. Hawkeye News, leadership you can depend on.
Welcome to our final edition of Hawkeye News for the 2003-2004 school year. I am Rachel Selvey.
And I'm Christian Henson.
It's time for senior walk, prom, and graduation in this final month of the school year. It's also time for seniors like myself to look back at our high school years while looking forward to our college and career years that are just ahead, as we have to work hard to keep our academic goals in focus the remainder of the year.
That's right, Rachel. And with prom and so many other warm weather events coming up, it can be hard to think of homework and studying. Many of us have been busy this past month with activities in school. So this month, we'll take a look back at April and a look ahead to some of the events coming up in the 2004-2005 school year.
But first, we begin with this month's top stories. As we film this month's show, we are still looking forward to senior walk, prom, and graduation. But by the time our show airs, we will have already enjoyed the walk with prom and graduation straight ahead. This year's senior walk and luncheon, sponsored by the Red Oak High School PTA, was once again a big success. The event was held on Friday, May 7th at the Waxahachie Civic Center. The event was a time for seniors to look back at the past 4 years. All the seniors would like to thank the PTA members who worked so hard to allow us this great event. We are also looking forward to another great prom that will be held on Saturday, May 22nd at the Dallas Apparel Mart. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Dilworth or Mrs. McGinnis. The final big event will come after press time as well. Graduation for the class of 2004. The graduation will once again be held at the beautiful Potter's House Church in Dallas at 4 o'clock p.m. Congratulations, graduates of 2004, and best wishes in the future.
Many of us remember the first time we saw Hawk. Some of us were just in elementary school when he came in to show off his drug-finding abilities and to get hugs and pats on the head. Yes, it hardly seems like it has almost been 9 years since Red Oak ISD Chief Lindsay brought Hawk home to Red Oak to help keep drugs out of Red Oak schools. Purchased in November of 1995, Hawk was placed on duty as Red Oak ISD's first canine narcotics dog. Hawk has worked in the schools ever since that time, helping to locate illegal drugs on school property and hopefully giving students a reason not to bring such things to schools. Hawk was purchased from TSK K9 in Austin, Texas, and was originally from Germany. He has served the district as well, and as of June 1st, will be officially retired and soon will be replaced by Red Oak ISD K9 Rowdy, who will be picked up over the summer. Rowdy will be under the supervision of Red Oak ISD Police Department's Officer Eric Scott, who will train with Rowdy over the summer. We will bring you a closer look at Rowdy next school year, but for now we would like to say thanks to Hawk for all of his hard work. Happy retirement, Hawk.
It's time to welcome back our junior high reporter, Katie Stanglin, for her final junior high in review segment.
We are excited that Katie will be moving to the West Campus and will bring us a new segment next year called What's New at the WC. But for now, let's see what good news is going on at Red Oak Junior High this final month.
Katie?
Hello, Red Oak Junior High. It's May and the last month of school, though for me it'll be my last junior high in review. So go with me as we take a closer look at what's been up during this last short month of school.
In Haddock News, recently they helped out the new SPCA that will soon be opening in Ellis County. They had the students bring in items for the animal shelter, and whatever they brought, Haddock matched the same item for the shelter. We thank them for helping the community, and I know the shelter really appreciated it. As most of you all know, Miss Kim Patty is the drama teacher here at ROJH, but what you might not have known is that her daughter, Daisy Dotson, will be a third-generation varsity cheerleader at the high school next year. Miss Patty's mom was a varsity cheerleader who graduated with the class of 62, and Miss Patty was also a varsity cheerleader who graduated with the class of 81. Now Daisy will become a varsity cheerleader next year and follow in her family's footsteps. Three generations of cheerleaders isn't too strange, but it's three generations at the same high school that cheered for the same squad. Now that's pretty interesting. Who knows, maybe there'll be a fourth generation from their family in years to come.
This year has really flown by, and next year I'll be a big freshman on campus. I've really enjoyed my time here at Hawkeye News, and I'm looking forward for years to come. Well, it's time to say goodbye. I'm Katie Stanglin, Hawkeye News.
Now in its 16th year, the annual kindergarten rodeo was recently held at Eastridge Elementary. Ms. Taylor stated that the program was started in place of field day at Shields Elementary some 16 years ago while working with Ms. Jenny Powers. When Ms. Powers moved to Eastridge, the rodeo began as a first-come, first-served program that is limited to two elementary schools each year. In the rodeo, the kindergarten teachers have the kids make some type of stick horse. They will have trash cans to double as corrals for the horse when not in use. The kids use the horses to run barrels using pylons. Ms. Taylor uses high school students who are interested in rodeo. She told us that in the past years, some of the high school students have actually competed in rodeos, and some other years they are mainly greenhorns. Teachers help organize about 10 events for the kids, such as cow chip or horseshoe toss. They also have the tame bucking barrel for a pony ride. The high school students also bring animals to the event for a petting zoo for the little kids. Ms. Taylor also said she's always amazed at just what a great job the high school students do with the younger students, and knows the impact on these little hawks is one that will last for years to come. Ms. Taylor said another one of the fun events is chasing off the rodeo clowns by the kids. Of all things Ms. Taylor does at Red Oak High School, there are many. She said that the rodeo is her favorite. If you are a high school student interested in participating in the rodeo next year, contact Ms. Taylor. The rodeos are fun for both high school and elementary students alike, and we are proud that this wonderful tradition lives on in Red Oak ISD.
This month's District in 60 Seconds is brought to you by DeSoto Feed and Animal Rescue, proud sponsors of Red Oak ISD PD's canine, Hawk.
In my final District in 60 Seconds, we take a look at rabbits in school, students showing off technology skills, students helping other students with life-changing choices, and learning about NASA, all in this month's District in 60 Seconds. Shields students visit NASA right here at home. Recently, the fourth graders from Shields Elementary were treated to a video conference learning session from NASA in Houston. The students learned about NASA and were able to interact with the presenter by asking and answering questions. Shattered Dreams called a big success. Project Success and Haddock are proud to announce the 2004 Shattered Dreams program as a big success, thanks to all the students who did such a great job on the program. Rabbits visit Wooden Elementary. Wooden Elementary first graders were treated to a big surprise as one of their own classmates, Josh Shell, and his mom, Alicia, brought their pet rabbits to class to teach students about rabbits and how to care for animals. Red Oak ISD Tech Fair, a big success. Red Oak ISD Technology Coordinator Steve Miller recently announced the first annual Red Oak ISD Technology Fair was a big success with over 300 entries submitted to the fair. Cinco de Mayo celebrated with music and dance. Recently, some of Mrs. Forty's Spanish class students took part in the annual Cinco de Mayo celebration by learning a traditional dance of the Spanish culture. The entire class enjoyed the dance, and the students did a great job while learning. And that's your district in 60 seconds.
The end of the school year does not mean the end for some of our student athletes, as many have kept the season alive with playoffs and regional tournaments.
For more on this, we go to our sports anchor, Brady Sapp, who joins us poolside. Brady?
Thanks, ladies. With the end of school just around the corner, most sports action is winding down, but the end did not come before playoffs and regional qualifications in baseball, softball, golf, and track and field. We will bring you much more after a word from our sponsor.
This month's Hawkeye News Sports is brought to you by State Farm, Danny Humphreys.
kick off this month with a word from our Lady Hawk softball team as they kept their long streak alive, making another playoff appearance this season, going 6-4 in District 16 4A play and taking a third place spot in District and moving into the playoffs against a tough Cleveland Lady Yellow Jackets team. In a season that has been one for rebuilding after a loss of several seniors last year, the team has once again done what it takes to get into this tournament. The Lady Hawks opened the playoffs on April 29th against the district runner-up Cleburne Yellow Jackets. The game was played in Mansfield with the Lady Hawks coming out on top in what could be called an upset over the second place team from District 15-4A by a score of 10-5. The ladies were led by Jessica Plemons, who was 3-for-4 with 2 singles, a triple, and 4 RBIs. Joy Pruitt, who was 2-for-3 with a single, a double, 2 runs scored, and 2 stolen bases. Tiffany Pearson and Julia Robertson also had 2 hit games, and the offense pounded out 10 runs on 12 hits, while Coach Garcia called Justine Pruitt the defensive player of the game with 9 putouts and 2 assists. Julia Robertson was the winning pitcher, holding down the powerful Lady Jackets most of the night. The Lady Hawks are scheduled to take on district champion Nacogdoches on Thursday, May 6th in Athens, which will be after press time in the area around. We will miss several of the Lady Hawks who are part of the class of 2004 and would like to thank all these ladies who worked hard in the past 4 years. Congratulations to Coach Garcia, Coach Henry, and Coach Zuniga on another great season of Lady Hawks softball.
In baseball news, the Red Oak Hawks varsity baseball team has made it back-to-back playoff years with a third-place finish in District 16-4A this season.
The Hawks, after starting a season with the loss to Terrell and Ennis, got back on track in beating Maybank and Lancaster before dropping a close one to Corsicana. Going into the second half at 2-3, the Hawks knew it would take at least a 3-2 finish in the second half to give them a playoff berth. Behind some great pitching performances of seniors Josh Curry and Charlie Duncan, the Hawks fought their way to beat Terrell, Maybank, and Lancaster in the second half. The Hawks dropped a hard-fought game at home to close out the season at Corsicana by a score of 6-3. But senior Josh Curry did add some excitement late in the game as he hit a towering home run over the left field fence to narrow the game. The loss put the Hawks at 5-5 in district play. The third place finish would land the Hawks in a playoff matchup against District 15-4A runner-up Cleburne, which will be played after press time.
In track and field, the Hawks sent 2 males and 2 female athletes to the regional meet held April 30th and May 1st in Denton.
On the guys' side, pole vaulters Tim Carroll and Brad Rogers qualified for regionals, with Rogers finishing 6th place in the meet. On the girls' side, Deanna Smith joined a fellow teammate in shot put, Deandra Carter, at the regional meet. Dee also competed in the discus event. Dee once again showed the Carter dominance as she won the discus event on Friday, throwing for 158 feet 1 inches to break the regional record that was previously held by her big sister last year. On Saturday, Dee placed first and Deanna placed second in regionals, qualifying them for state. We wish Dee the best of luck as she will compete for the state title later this month. We will bring you the results from state in our first show of the 2004-2005 school year.
Our final story this month is on our regional qualifying golf athletes.
This year, on the girls' side, junior Jana Bronnenberg qualified for regionals and had a pretty good tournament in horrible golf conditions, with winds in the high 30-mile-per-hour range. On the boys' side, senior Ryan Griggs shot a 158 in the tournament, placing him 15 out of 92 competitors. Junior Eric Shutman shot a 169 in the tournament and should be in the hunt for the district and regionals as he returns for the senior season next year. Congratulations to all the Red Oak High School golfers and to Coach Steve Williams for another successful year.
That about wraps it up for another awesome year of sports action for the Hawks and Lady Hawks. We would again like to thank all the student athletes for representing our school with class and pride. Thanks to the coaches and fans, and a special thanks to Ms. Sandy Stanglin for all our help in providing the scores and information to show you this year. Until we lace it up for another football season in August, I'm Brady Sapp. Thanks for watching.
In a follow-up to last month's story on the Mighty Hawk Band by our own Tamara Llewellyn, we wanted to give you one last look at the results of the state competition for our Mighty Hawk Band. If you'd like to find out more about our Mighty Hawk Band, you can check out the band website at www.redoakband.com. This month, we welcome back our crime reporter, Natalie Hillary, as she brings us the final details on the new drug testing policy for extracurricular activities next year. Nat?
That's right, Rachel and Christian. In one of the most meaningful votes in the years, the Red Oak ISD Board of Trustees voted 5-0 to implement random drug testing for all extracurricular activities beginning in the 2004-2005 school year.
As we reported last month, the program is being done at several schools across the United States as an incentive for students to stay drug and alcohol free. The board heard 1-4 and 1-against the proposal at the meeting in April, but voted unanimously to support the recommendation for drug testing. The policy will officially take place the first day of school for the 2004-2005 school year. Students are being encouraged now to seek help if they believe they have a drug problem. Students who need help can contact the counselor's office for referrals to drug treatment. The administration hopes that students will take this opportunity to help themselves so that no one has to fail a drug test, and thus no one will have to give up the extracurricular activities they love. It is clear that Red Oak ISD has made a stance that our school should be an example to others, that our athletes and others involved in extracurricular activities should be drug-free and pure in body and mind when representing our school. While some may not agree with drug testing, it is clear that we all now have one big reason to keep ourselves from doing drugs, which can and have ruined many others' lives.
If you or your parents would like more information on drug testing, you may contact Mr. Shumman, who will be the official testing coordinator. I'm Natalie Hillary, reporting for Hawkeye News.
They say in Hawaii that aloha means hello and goodbye. Unfortunately for many friends and admirers of School Board President Mr. Rick Jackson, it will soon be the goodbye version, as Mr. Jackson and his wife Vicki will be moving to Hawaii in late May. Mr. Jackson has been a member of the Red Oak ISD Board of Trustees since May 1994 and has served as Board President since May 2000. Mr. Jackson is also well known to many Red Oak High School students for always being willing to help with special projects at all the schools. Many of us who have worked on Chatter Dreams will have fond memories of Mr. Jackson. He has taken part in Chatter Dreams programs in both 2001 and our recent 2004 event. Mr. Jackson is the team pastor of Mission and Magnification at First Baptist Church in Red Oak and has served in that capacity since August 1988. Mr. and Mrs. Jackson have had three children graduate from Red Oak High School, Randy, Ricky, and Lauren, who was a 2003 graduate. The Jacksons will be moving and will begin a new chapter of their ministry as they will operate a ministry of marriage vows and renewal service on the island of Maui. Recently, First Baptist Church held a special praise and worship concert to honor the ministry of the Jacksons for the past 17 years. A special part of the event for Project Success Drug Education, the parent organization and sponsor of Hawkeye News, was a presentation of a beautiful plaque to Mr. Jackson for all his help and support with the Mr. and Mrs. Red Oak pageants, where he ran sound for the pageant since it began, as well as his participation and support of Shattered Dreams in 2001 and 2004. Mr. Jackson will be staying to be a part of the graduation ceremony on May 29th, but will be leaving for his new home on May 30th. We wish the Jacksons a wonderful future, and from all of us at Red Oak ISD, we would like to say thank you again for all you have meant to the district.
The end of the year many times brings special memories and sometimes even goodbyes. This year will be no exception, as many of us here at Hawkeye News will say goodbye to the one and only special senior member of our team, Rachel Selvey. Rachel has been involved for 2 years with the show and has been a desk anchor for both years. Rachel has brought true leadership to Hawkeye News team with her warm smile and contagious laugh. She has always been the ultimate professional, and producer Alan Oliver brings us his final look at a true Hawkeye News pioneer.
Every day is so wonderful, and suddenly it's hard to breathe. Now and then I get insecure from all the pain. I'm so ashamed. I am beautiful no matter what they say. Words can't bring me down. I am beautiful in every single way. Yes, words can't bring me down, no, no. So don't you bring me down today. To all your friends, you're delirious, so consumed. Trying hard to fill the emptiness.
Rachel, we know as you close the chapter of your life and head on to Texas State that even bigger and better things await you. Thanks from all of us here at Hawkeye News for making the past 2 years a great experience. From producers Alan and Kimberly Oliver, from Chief Scott Lindsay, and all of us here at Hawkeye News, we love you and we'll miss you.
Before we go, it's time for all of us to take our embarrassment one more time as producer Alan Oliver brings us one more look at those bloopers, blunders, and outtakes from the entire year of Hawkeye News. It's time once again to welcome back our junior high correspondent, Katie Stay.
If you would like to join Hannett, pick up an applet.
We check back for our district results.
We'll take a look at some of the.
After a word from our good folks at Rango Collision.
I'm working on it, all right? Jeez, man. Anybody bring any duct tape with them? I'm telling you.
That about does it for another month of busy sports. Listen to daily announcements for more.
Not only with health, but mental and emotional damage that can last a lifetime. Tamara. What's new in sports this month, Brady?
Well, Rachel and Christian, I hate you guys.
Thanks, JD. We like.
Oh, ho, boys and girls, Merry Christmas.
Hi.
Oh.
3.
2-1. Sorry. Yeah. We won't watch you.
3, 2.
And we look forward to hearing much more about your.
Maybe this belt will stretch out. Oh, you're not getting that on camera. You're such a punk.
Oh,
Brady, what are you doing?
Well, girls, I've got to go. I've got lots of boys and girls to get ready. I've got lots of toys to get ready for boys and girls.
Lots of boys and girls.
Lots of boys and girls.
Shaq is We are excited that Kato will be moving to the West Campus and will bring us a new segment next year called What's New at the WC. But for now, let's go to. Dang it! So by the time our show airs, we will have already.
That is right, and one of the most meaningful votes in the years. And for this, we go to our Hawkeye News Junior High reporter, Katie Stanglin, with this month's Junior High Review. Katie, crackle, crackle.
Mrs. Little is known as one of the top theater arts teachers in the Dutchess Smith.
We look forward to bringing you our. I know, I'm sorry. Hawk will remain with Chief Lindsay and will still be available.
We are excited that Kate will be moving to the West Campus and will bring us a new segment next year called What's New at the WC. But for now, let's see what good news. We wish the Jacksons a wonderful future, and for all of us at Red Oak ISD, we would like to say thank you again for all who. Brady?
Thanks, Rachel.
Here we go. 30 minutes.
From the highs of big wins in sports, academics, one act, I'm blind.
Crap, you said that. Bad news. My eyes.
As many have kept the season alive with.
A bug went up my nose.
A bug went up
my nose.
Sweet.
Red Oak High School Theater Arts has always been.
Sorry, I'm stomach growl. Don't beat their face.
What's new in sports this month, Brady?
Well, Rachel and Christian, we take a look at another season of.
Thanks for being here, Katie.
What am I supposed to do?
Thanks for watching and make it a great day. It's time for sports with sports anchor Brady Sepp.
Stop laughing at me.
Shower.
Okay, back to one.
My elbow just got hot. And now it's time for sports with Brady Sepp. Brady?
I enjoy toasting.
What's new in sports this month? Who's there? This is Robert King.
Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
I messed up.
For Hawkeye News, this is Robert Kent signing off.
Bam! Oh, how about that?
As you can see, it has been another busy month and year for Red Oak High School students, as well as others around the district. Our school has experienced many emotions this year, from the highs of big wins in sports, academics, one-act, choir, band, drill team, and much more, to the very lows of the loss of friends and serious accidents.
Well, I'll be moving on to college along with many of my 2004 classmates. We want to say thank you to Mr. Shupman, the assistant principals, our teachers, counselors, and all others who have helped us along the way. We want to wish the rest of you a wonderful school year in 2004-2005. And we hope that you have enjoyed watching Hawkeye News again this year as much as we have enjoyed bringing it to you. Thanks as always to our producers, Alan and Kimberly Oliver, to our reporters, photojournalists, and all those who have supported us. I'd like to wish Christian and Natalie the best of luck next year on the desk, as well as the rest of the Hawkeye News team. Thanks for allowing us into your classroom. If you'd like to contact us with your news ideas, comments, or suggestions, you can give us a call at 972-617-4312, mailbox number 4, or you can write to us at hawkeyenews@redoakisd.org.
I'm Rachel Selby.
And I'm Christian Henson. Thanks for watching, and from all of us here at Hawkeye News,
have a safe and happy summer.